So we have chemistry. It can be divided into three parts. One is known as physical chemistry. This is known as, the next one is inorganic chemistry. And then there is organic chemistry. So for physical chemistry, the basic chapter for physical chemistry is the first chapter, chapter one. That is some basic concepts in chemistry. Okay, some basic concepts. That is the basics and the foundation of physical chemistry. In organic chemistry, the foundation here is quantum numbers. The first chapter that we are dealing with here, atomic structure, quantum numbers. Then periodic properties. And chemical bonding. Okay, so these three chapters are the basis, and this is the hierarchy. The most important is the quantum numbers. From quantum numbers, you will understand the periodic properties. From periodic properties, you will understand why different elements in different groups of the periodic table react with each other. Okay, so quantum numbers, periodic properties, and chemical bonding. Organic chemistry, the first chapter of organic chemistry is some basic concepts and principles, some basic principles and techniques, some basic principles and techniques in organic chemistry. That is, I guess, in the second book, and we deal all these things in general organic chemistry. We call this GOC. Okay, GOC. So now, what we are going to learn about the quantum numbers in the chapter two, that is most important. Coming to the chapter two, Chapter two has two parts. Okay, the history of atomic structure. In that, you will understand the discovery of electron, discovery of proton, neutron, then the models of atom. Okay, and in this model, we will have the Rutherford model. You will have the Bohr model, Thomson model, right? So Thomson model and also the Bohr model, Rutherford model, and the Thomson model. You would have learned all these three models in the class 10th also, but we will be dealing in depth with Bohr model. Rutherford model and the Thomson model has been parts of chemistry.
So now
we will deal with Bohr model. Okay, wait a second. How is it now?
Still lagging, sir.
Still lagging?
Yes, sir.
And what about now?
It's okay now, sir.
Fine, okay. So, Bohr model, right? And we will study Bohr model in detail. We will see what are the relationship between the energy and waves. And then we will also learn about the wave-particle duality of electron, wave-particle duality of electron. So all these things, they have nothing to do. And the next portion, we can call it as quantum numbers. Okay, quantum numbers. So these two portions are independent of each other. I mean, there is a relation, but they are not dependent. Do you understand this? There is a relationship between them, between the first portion of atomic history of atomic structure and the quantum numbers. There is a relationship between them, but they are not dependent on each other, right? For example, you have friends now. You have friends, so that friendship is a relationship, right? But friends can be independent too. You can do your project on your own. He can or she can do her own project, right? So these two things are related, but not dependent on each other. And this is more important for you. Quantum numbers is more important because quantum numbers will help you in the chapter three, in the chapter four. Then also the P block elements, the S block elements. Okay. Now, if you gain mastery, you have to gain mastery. If you gain mastery, no, there is no option. You have to gain mastery in quantum numbers. So let us start with quantum numbers. I guess who are present here? Okay, Yusra is also okay. Yusra is also. Assalamu alaikum, Yusra. How are you?
Welcome, Salam, sir. I'm fine.
Alhamdulillah. You were. I'm also fine. Thank you. But you were absent in yesterday's class. What yes, happened?
Sir, actually, yesterday I had some network issues as well, and we had to do some packing because tomorrow morning or maybe today evening we'll have to leave.
To for India? Rad.
No, sir. For Rad.
Okay. By the way, I'm really happy everyone is at time. Yesterday, many were not at time. Okay. Safwan, how are you? आज आप सुबह गए जिम?
जी सर।
अच्छा छुट्टी कब होती है आपके जिम में?
दो घंटे बाद सर। जब भी जाते हैं।
दो घंटा जिम करते हैं आप?
हाँ सर नॉर्मल टाइम वही है।
दो लोगों का जिम कर लेते हैं क्या?
सर एक घंटा तो फिर कार्डियो करते हो।
एक घंटा कार्डियो करते हो?
जी सर नॉर्मल है सर।
अरे नॉर्मल नहीं है। ओके एनीवन हियर गोस टू जिम?
मी सर लाइक व्हेन आई वाज देयर आई जॉइन।
अच्छा सो
यस सर आई गो।
अच्छा नाउ इज 2 आवर्स नॉर्मल?
यस सर फॉर मी इट्स नॉर्मल।
Sir, it depends upon his vision. Means if he's
yes, sir.
If he's an old gymmer, he can go. Means for there is very big possibilities. They are even doing for 2.5 and 3 hours also.
Sir, sometimes they do.
Depends
for,
upon the
calories also. It depends on calories also.
Mm-hmm. I used to think 1 hour is fine. 2 hours.
Sir, I also use for 1.5 and 1. Yeah, exactly. So,
sir, sometimes it depends on calories also.
Cardio, I'm not doing more because I'm not as a beginner. Also, I start maybe for 3 or 4 months like that.
Okay. Yeah, it depends on. I mean, how much calories you wanna burn or how much calories you have consumed.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Exactly.
Okay, fine. Let us come to quantum numbers. Okay, let us come to quantum numbers. So, give the heading. Quantum numbers. Now, before starting quantum numbers, I came across a very nice quote from Mark Twain. Mark Twain is an English writer. Anyone heard of Mark Twain?
Sir, yes, I have sir. Heard about him.
You have heard of Mark Twain? Okay, so I came across a quote of his. Wow. And his quote is, I have never let my schooling interfere with my dash. Can somebody guess what is this dash here? I have never let my schooling interfere with my dash.
Hobbies. Oh.
Hobbies, okay. Somebody said hobbies. Anyone else?
Job, hobbies.
Job. You said job.
I know. Maybe so. I know. Well, because I have heard it from my father. Maybe it's education.
Yes, it is education. I have never let my schooling interfere with my education. So you guys also never let your schooling interfere with your education. Education is what you are learning, what you are studying. And if you think that school is not doing a good job in that, then you don't let the schooling interfere with your education. Okay, that means also education is does not, I mean, it can come from, but it is necessarily not from schooling, right? So please keep in mind this quote. I really found this very interesting take on schoolings. I have never let my schooling interfere with my education. back to quantum numbers. Now, what is quantum numbers? Whenever I say quantum numbers, then you will translate this in your head. Address of electron. We'll translate this to address of electron. Okay, Maitri. I think I have taken one class for Maitri. Just wait a second. There is a student who is joining. Let me see. Yes. Okay. Address of electron. What is quantum numbers, Aisha? Your mic got off, yeah?
It's the address of electron.
Yes. Okay. Safwan, what is quantum numbers? Quantum numbers tells about? Quantum numbers tells about?
Address of electron.
Address of electron. Okay. Samaira, quantum numbers tells about?
Address of electron.
Address of electron. Okay, meeting ID has been changed, I guess. Okay, so this is for waiting room participants. Okay. Not for us. Okay. Address of electron. No. After writing quantum numbers and writing like this address of electron, write the definition of quantum numbers, the set of four numbers which gives the status of an electron.
You should write this quantum numbers.
Yes. Okay. Write this. Write with me in different orbits. On my energy levels. This is an energy level is called. Okay. You can also write another definition or the set of four numbers which gives the shape, size, and orientation of orbital in which an electron is present, is called quantum numbers. Quantum numbers. As we have seen, there are four quantum numbers. Okay, there are four quantum numbers. Now, those four quantum numbers are what? There are four quantum numbers. Okay, four quantum numbers are, the first one is principal quantum number, This is denoted by the letter small n. This is denoted by the letter small n. Second one is azimuthal. Quantum number. This is denoted by the small letter L. Then you have the magnetic quantum number. This is defined as M. And at last, we have spin quantum. Number which is defined denoted as S, okay, which is denoted as S. Please write this. Let me know when you are done. Then I will ask you a few questions.
Sir, what's the second quantum number?
Azimuthal, Azimuthal, okay. Azimuthal quantum number. I've written azimuthal in the chat also. Please, this is for everyone. So the spelling azimuthal.
That's it.
Okay, please raise your hand. There are a lot of students. I will forget. Okay, Mariam is done, Ikra is done. Okay, just waiting for Yusra now. Okay, Yusra is also okay. Now, can anyone tell me not their address, but any kind of address? Oh yes, do one thing. Can someone Google address of Sherlock Holmes? Or does anyone remember Sherlock Holmes? It is one of the most famous addresses, right?
Yes.
Can someone please Google the address of Sherlock Holmes and dictate it to me?
Sir, with the numbers, sir, and everything?
Yes, with the numbers,
sir,
and everything.
It's 221B Baker Street.
Okay, so it is 221B.
B. Baker Street.
Yeah, that is why I know Baker Street. And after this?
London W16XE.
Okay, it is then London.
NW1 6XE United Kingdom,
UK. Okay, and also, does anyone know which floor was he used to live in this apartment, in this building, which floor? No one? First floor?
Yes, a ground floor.
Ground floor or first floor?
First floor,
yeah. Mariam, you said ground floor?
Yes, sir.
No, ground floor mein toh, his landlord had that shop, I guess, na?
Yes, sir.
In the first floor, yeah. What was the name of his landlord? Mrs. Hudson, yeah. Mrs. Hudson. So, let us do one thing. Let us not worry about these numbers, that is London. We will focus on this, that is 221B Baker Street. So obviously you will have a street number. Wherever you give the address, there will be a street. Okay, there will be a street. Now, if you are giving address to anyone, you will tell the street. If you are giving your home's address to anyone, you will tell them your street, what street you live in. Now, if you are giving the address to someone who is already in your street, you will give the building number. Correct? You will give the building number. Now, if you are giving the address to someone, if you want someone from your own building to come in your house, then what will you give? The apartment number of the floor number, right? Apartment number. Correct? Any doubt?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So these are the same things for electrons also. Okay. These are the same things for electrons also. What is happening here is, let me just erase these things. Let me copy these numbers and put it here. Okay. So what does that mean? It means that the principal quantum number, it will tell you about the street. And then we will have as azimuthal quantum number, it will tell you about the building number. And magnetic quantum number, it will tell you the apartment number. And then in apartment, when you have entered the apartment, you have approximately reached the electron. And this spin quantum number will just tell you inside, whenever you enter somebody's apartment, their parents will tell you, okay, that is her room or that is his room, right? They will let you know where is the orientation of your body. Where is Samaira, where is Aisha, where is Maryam and Safwan, okay, etc. Now, can you remember these three things only, please? At principal quantum number will tell you about the street. Azimuthal quantum number, yes.
What will be the, you give for number three, apartment number, yeah?
Yeah, apartment number.
And for number four, you will give the room?
Which room? Number four, no, as soon as if you are in the apartment, okay. I cannot specify now. I cannot specify which room you will be in. You can be in the hall also, right? So there is a kind of variable, but in the building, for example, in the street, there is a specific street which you will be in. There is a specific building which you will be in. There is a specific apartment number which you will be in. But in your own house, you can be anywhere. Correct?
Sir,
yes, sir.
Sir, so the spin quantum number means the exact location?
Yeah. Address of the electron. No? It will give you the address of the electron. Okay.
Okay,
sir. Address of the electron. Now, for address of the electron, you have to remember principal quantum number will give you kind of what we call as street in our real life. Azimuthal quantum number will tell you about kind of what we call as building number or how to identify which building is there. And then inside the building, you will get the apartment number. Okay. Now, let us move on.
So now we have reached second lesson, yeah?
Yes. This is second lesson.
Start my second lesson.
Yeah. Start of second lesson. But this is my style of starting the second lesson. In NCERT, you will have some different
starting
order of topics. Okay. Now.
Sir, your way is more easier than that in NCERT.
Thank you. Yeah, obviously. Because NCERT has some limitations. Now, they have to cater for each and every student in the CBSE board and also to the teachers, but I have to cater only to my own student. That is why I have some freedom. Now, write a concept of the street. Okay. Now you will learn about the street. How does the street of a particular atom, inside the atom, we have different shells. Na? That is the street of atom. So we will write the concept of orbit. Concept of orbit. First, write the definition. You already know the orbits, right? You already know the orbits because you would have learned about K, L, M, N, etc., right? So these are the orbits. But write the definition. This definition will be new. The non-radiating circular. The non-radiating circular path around the nucleus in which electron moves is called orbit. It's the first point. Second point, it is denoted by K, L, M, and so on, or by numbers. One, two, three, four, and so on. In class 11th and 12th, we will be preferring these numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 rather than the letters K, L, M, N, etc. Okay, so this is the orbit. Now, even as you see the definition of orbit, it says that it is a circular path. It is a circular path, very similar to the streets that we have, right? Very similar to the streets that we have. After writing the concept of orbit, write concept of orbits are also called as shell, right? I hope you guys know this.
Yes, sir, they are also shell.
Shell. Concept of suborbit or subshell. Concept of suborbit or subshell. Now, every street will contain some buildings, right? Every street will have some buildings.
Yes.
Yes.
Yes. Yes. Similarly, every shell, every shell or every orbit, they will consist of smaller regions called suborbit or subshell. Okay, easy to remember. Every orbit or shell consists of smaller region, small region called suborbit or subshell. We call it suborbit or subshell, right? Now, there are only a few types of buildings that you will see, right? There are only few types of building that you will see. Most of the buildings, they will look similar, right? Most of the buildings, they will look similar. So here also, the buildings of chemistry, the buildings in which electrons reside, they have some names. Name of subshell. Okay, then you have their spectral name. Now, the spectral name, you don't have to remember it because this is of no use for you, but it should be there in your notebook. Should be there in your notebook. So afterwards, if you study chemistry in your higher studies and you look at your 11th class notebook, you will be like, okay, fine, this is also present in my notebook. It is still useful. Name of the subshell, spectral name, the shape, and the maximum number of electron it can hold. Okay, so max number of electrons that can be present in a particular subshell. Okay, each building has their own limitations. Each building will have their own limitations in respect to the number of people that it can hold. Now, S subshell, there is S subshell, P subshell, B subshell, and F subshell. You must have heard of these subshells, right? Those who have covered this chapter, yes, in their chapter. Yeah. So where does this S come from? S come from the name that is sharp. P is from principal. B is diffused. F is fundamental. Now the shape of S subshell is spherical. So kind of like this. Then we have the P subshell, which has dumbbell shape. A dumbbell is something like this. Okay. And this one part here, it is known as lobe. So how many lobes are there in the P subshell?
Two.
Two lobes, very good. Cool. Diffused is double dumbbell. Double dumbbell. Now generally, double dumbbell is something like this. So how many lobes are there in D subshell?
Four.
Now F is complicated or complex. You don't have to learn about the shape of the F subshell. A maximum number of electron. So I will write a few here and I will ask you, for example, S subshell can hold maximum of two electrons. Can hold maximum of two electrons. P can hold maximum of six electrons. And F can hold maximum of 14 electrons. Okay, who can fill this gap here of D? There is a pattern here. Please in the chat, please send the answers in chat to Salim. Don't send. Yes, Safwan, correct. Very good. Okay. Yes, Shakir, correct. I just see the pattern. You have saw the pattern. You're not telling me the answer for here. Look at the pattern. Yes, Ikra, correct. Aisha, I can see that you have identified the pattern. Yes, Mariam, correct. No, see that. Yes, Yusra, correct. Okay, Aisha, what is the difference between 2 and 6?
2 and 6. Are you asking me about the number?
What is the difference between 2 and 6? I'm just asking that. The difference between 2 and 6?
2 is smaller number.
No, what is it? No. Difference, subtraction, difference.
Subtraction.
Okay, your mic got off.
Hello, sir. Actually, sir, I am having a little bit of problem here. 6 minus 2 is 4.
4, right? The difference is 4, right? So after that also, you will have a number 6 plus 4, that is 10. Then 10 plus 4 is?
14.
15, okay? 14. Now, if there comes to be a subshell whose name is G, now you don't have to remember this. This is ground or something. Gerard, shape. Again, it will be complex. What will be the maximum number of electrons the G subshell can hold? How many electrons can the G subshell hold?
18
electrons, right? Now you have saw the pattern. You don't need the G subshell as of now.
But in chemistry, we will not use G, yes, sir?
In what?
In chemistry, we will not use G.
No, you will not be using G. Okay. In chemistry, I mean, in the sense that in 11th and 12th standard, you just have to understand till F. Okay? Just need to know till F.
Yeah, but I didn't understand why you give shapes, spherical and lobe and double dumbbells.
So that you can identify, no? Where is the electron living? If it is in S subshell, then you can easily identify, okay, I have to go to the spherical house.
Okay.
I hope you guys have written everything down.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Done.
Done?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yeah, okay, fine. I guess everyone has done then. So let us write the concept of orbital. Concept of orbital. Now, when you will enter a building, there will be apartments. So what is orbital? Now in each apartment, there are smaller regions. In each building, there are smaller regions which are called apartments, right? In each building, there are smaller regions which are called apartments. Similarly, in each suborbit, it is further composed of smaller regions which are called orbital. Okay, so this is, please write this with me, every suborbit. Or subshell is further composed of smaller regions called orbital. Called orbital. Okay. Now, this next definition that I am going to write, this is important for your board examination. If any teacher asks you what is an orbital, so you will answer this particular definition. What is an orbital? The region or space around which, region or space around the nucleus, around the nucleus, where the probability of finding an electron is maximum. Okay, it's called as orbital. Yes, please raise your hand if you're done writing. We're just waiting for Safwan now. Yes, Safwan, raise your hand if you're done.
Sorry, 1 second, sir. Bas ye aakhri ka point baki rahe.
Okay. So I will again ask everyone to read a sentence and then write that particularly whole sentence in the sense that the region and space from here to here, and don't look the region, then write or space, then write. Don't do like that. Read the complete thing and then from memory, write it down. Safwan, you are still writing?
Done.
Done. Okay. Now you guys can lower your hands. Okay. Now you guys can lower your hands. Now we will do the quantum number. First quantum number is principal quantum number. Quantum number. Principal quantum number is denoted by which letter?
Yes.
Principal. Small n, right? It's denoted by small n. Also, I will refer to principal quantum number sometimes as PQN. Okay, I will sometimes refer the principal quantum number as PQN. Principal quantum number, it will tell you about one of the things. It will tell you about the one of the things. It will tell you about what? Street, building, or apartment. It will tell you about street, building, or apartment. Yeah.
Street.
So, what is street in chemistry? In electrons world, what is street?
Principal,
what is the word for
quantum number?
No, principal quantum number will tell you about the street. It will tell you about the street.
Orbit, or the shell.
Yeah, yes, Mitra. Yes, Samara. It is the shell or the orbit. So principal quantum number will, please write this with me. It gives the idea of orbit. It gives the idea of orbit in which the electron is present. in which the electron is present. Okay. Now, as soon as you will get the idea of orbit in which the electron is present, the next thing that you will understand also is, if it is very near to the, if any electron, there is a positive charge and there is a negative charge here. If it is nearby the positive charge, that means there is more attraction. And whenever there is more attraction, the energy will decrease. If a positive charge is here and a negative charge is here, it will move, right? It will move. Now, since it is moving very fastly here, what will happen if it is far away? The energy will be higher. Okay. So that means as soon as you get the idea of orbit, you will also get the idea of energy of the electron. It gives the idea of the energy of electron in orbit. Okay. If you know which orbit does it present, first orbit, second orbit, third orbit, then you also know the average distance from the nucleus. It gives the average distance of the electron from nucleus. Correct? Now, at last, it gives the size of orbit. Size of orbit. I hope you guys know that K shell is the smallest, then L shell, then M shell, right? Then N. Last point, it is very important. Last point is very important. That is the allowed values. Okay. So what are the allowed values of principal quantum numbers? So principal quantum number will be a number. Okay. What numbers can it be? It can be either 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and so on. Okay. So if somebody will tell you, let me give you a question here. I think you have written the first point. Identify the prohibited value of PQN. And they have given 1, 6, 0, and 8. So which of the value of principal quantum number is prohibited in this question? Zero, no? So you will take only
zero.
Yeah. Okay. So everyone understand this question? Because allowed values starts from one, no? Shakir. So zero is prohibited.
Okay.
These are the only allowed values, okay?
It starts from one, yeah, means.
Yeah, it starts from one.
Okay.
Then it can have any number after one. It can even have 1012, but it cannot be zero. 1, any whole number. No, it can be. I'm not saying it will be. It can be any whole number, but it will not be zero. Okay. Is everyone done?
The last digit should not be zero.
No, the last digit, no, I'm not saying that.
Okay. Only zero, yeah?
Yeah, it cannot be -1, it cannot be -2, it cannot be the negative, it can be only numbers.
Whole numbers, yeah.
Yeah, just the whole numbers.
Done.
Okay, everyone done? Safwan, aapko samajh mein aa raha hai? Are you following? Yes, Safwan.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. So just waiting for Safwan and Samaira. Okay, Samaira is also done. Safwan is also done. Great. So we are done with principal quantum number, right? Azimuthal quantum number. Second. Azimuthal quantum number. Azimuthal quantum number is denoted by which letter?
N.
L.
Can some
L.
L. Yeah. Okay, this is L. And I will sometimes refer azimuthal quantum number as AQN. As AQN. Okay. Now, azimuthal quantum number will tell us about what? Will tell us about?
The street. The building number. The building.
Building, na?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes. So, what is the building in electrons world?
Suborbit.
Subshells.
Subshells. Very good. Subshell. Okay. So, see, you know now quantum numbers is easy for you now, right? It gives the idea of subshell in a given shell. Now, this is very important. In a given shell, that means the subshell in a particular given shell can be different. If we are talking about one, the shell number one, the first orbit, the first shell, it would have some different azimuthal quantum number, right? So it depends on, I can say that the subshell depends on the shell, right? The subshell will be depending on the shell, correct or not? Now, next point, the allowed values. The allowed values, this is equal to 0 to n minus 1, where n is equal to the principal quantum number. N is equal to principal quantum number. Now we will also like to know, we have seen the subshells as what? We have seen the subshells as SPDF. So we would like to know what are the values of L and what are the name of those subshells. Okay. So how will you relate it? Name of subshell. And the value of L. Okay. And values of L. Now please remember that. Please remember that. Now, in a particular street, if you have, this is your street, there can be many buildings, right? There can be many buildings. Yes or no? Similarly, in a given shell, there can be many subshell. In a given cell, there can be many subshell. That is why 0 to n minus 1. S has the value of 0. P has the value of 1. D has the value of 2. And F has the value of 3. Okay. So if the value of L comes to be zero, then you will understand it is S subshell, is spherical in shape. If the value of L, it comes to be one, you will understand it is P and P with dumbbell shape. Okay. So first write this thing. Then when we will calculate the azimuthal quantum numbers, then you will understand it better. Yusra is done. Okay, Samaira is done. Waiting for Ikra, Maryam, Safwan. Okay, Maryam is done. Waiting for Ikra and Safwan. Ikra, are you following? Any doubts?
No, sir. Okay.
Safwan, just let me know if you're done. Okay, Safwan is done. Now, they also write one more point here. For example, if you know the value of L, it gives the idea of shape of subshell. Right. Shape of subshell, because if you have got zero, the value zero of L, that means it is the S subshell, and that means it is the spherical in shape. That means it is spherical in shape. Now, write a question. Calculate the number of, other calculate the subshell present in following helps. So part A, now I need someone. Okay. Mariam, is your internet strong?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So for first shell, okay, for first shell, this is the first shell and the value of L. So we'll write L is equal to, can you please repeat the formula? L is equal to what? The allowed values of L is, Mariam?
Zero to n minus one.
Okay, this is the formula. Okay. So zero to n minus one, we will again start with zero, two. What is the n here?
Zero.
One.
N is one, na?
N cannot be zero, yes, sir, because it's for PQN.
No.
But one minus one will be zero, right?
I'm not asking that. I'm asking n minus one is, just leave that, because we are not calculating for n, we are calculating for L. So we have not said that L cannot be zero, right? L has only one formula.
One.
So it will be one.
One, sir.
Zero.
Okay, fine. I am asking Mariam, so I would please kind of have a bit of respect, because if I am talking to a particular student, you would also not want anyone to interfere, no?
Sir.
Yeah, okay. So if you have a doubt or something, please raise your hand, then I will ask you, okay? Yes, Mariam, what is n?
One.
Yes. So we will write one minus one, right?
Yes, sir.
Because? So this will be equal to zero. Because zero to zero, it doesn't have any sense. That is why it will be zero. Correct, Mariam?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, please don't write anything as of now. Part B, we will calculate the, okay, now if it is zero, then which shell it is? Sorry, which subshell?
Yes.
Subshell is, yeah, very good. Subshell is equal to S. That means in the first orbit, there is only S subshell. Now tell me, deja vu ho jayega aap logo. You will have deja vu. Why? How many electrons can be filled? How many electrons can be there in the K orbit?
Two.
Why two? Now you know the answer, because K means the first shell. In first shell, there is only S subshell, and S subshell has the maximum number of electrons. It can hold how many electrons?
Zero.
Zero electrons? No. It cannot.
S
subshell, yes. Maximum number of electrons. See in the concept of subshell.
Two.
Maximum, yeah, two. Its value is zero. S value is zero, but it can hold two electrons. Okay. S value is how much? Zero. The value of S is zero. Okay. The L is equal to zero. If it is S, the L is equal to zero. Okay. Now let us come to B. Aisha, you will tell me now. It is the second shell. Okay. It is the second shell. Now Aisha, tell me what is L is equal to. Please tell me the formula.
It is equal to.
L is equal to. Okay, you are not audible. Ikra, can you tell me? L is equal to?
0 to n minus 1.
0 to n minus 1. So we'll start with how? 0 to, yes, Ikra, what is n?
2
minus 1. So this is equal to 0.
Is it audible now? Hello.
I will ask you, Aisha, okay? Just wait a second. Yes, Ikra? 0 to?
2, 1.
1. So this is, what is the value of L? L is from 0 to 1. Now, what subshells will be present? Which subshells will be present here for 0, Ikra?
0 is S.
S, and for 1?
P.
So S and P subshells are in the second shell. How many electrons can be present? How many electrons can be there in the second shell? Sorry, how many electrons can be present in the S subshell? Yes, Ikra, how many electrons in S?
2.
How many electrons in P?
6.
Add them, it is equal to 8. And you have learnt in 10th standard that in the L In the second orbit, there can be only 8 electrons. Yes?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Shakir, are you following?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Aisha, how is your internet now? Can you speak?
Sir, should I write this also? No, because we talked, stop writing.
Yes, yes. Now you can start writing.
Okay.
Aisha, can you speak? L is equal to?
Sir, actually my net is okay, but the problem is with my mic. I don't know. It's stuck sometimes whenever I'm trying to open it or close it or try to open anything. And I don't know, my small brother did something with my laptop. That's why it's stucking a lot.
So you're using the laptop's mic or you're using an earphone?
Earphone, sir.
You're using an earphone and you're using a laptop, na?
Yes, sir.
Okay, then go to that part where you have the audio button where you can mute and unmute. There is a small down arrow. There will be a small down arrow or an up arrow. Click that.
Yes, sir.
Then there is a select a microphone option.
Yeah.
In that, what are the options? Can you please tell me?
Microphone, array, jack mic, same as system.
CMS system and there is an array.
Yeah.
Can you please click on the array one?
Sir, it's clicked on array only.
Array only? Then what is the other
hanging one? It's hanging a lot. It's being stuck.
What is the other option? Okay, your laptop is hanging. Okay.
Yeah, actually my small brothers are playing.
Why don't you use a phone then? Phone
you I'm not able to just same phone. It's really small.
Then you can join with two devices.
Well, let's see. I guess it will be okay till tomorrow.
Okay, fine. Okay, Shakir, help me with this one then.
So what's it? Can I answer it?
Okay,
sir. You can answer in the chat. You can answer in the chat, Aisha.
Yes, sir.
Yes, L is equal to?
L is equal to 0 to n minus 1.
Very good.
Yes.
And now, what we will write next?
0 to 3 minus 1.
Very good.
0 is equal to 2. 0 to 2.
To 2. Then what will be the subshells?
SPD.
SP and D.
Yes.
So S can hold how many electrons?
2, 6. 2 for S, 6 for P. And 10 for D.
This is equal to how many electrons? How many? 18.
18.
Yeah. Right. So now you understand. You wrote this thing at 2, 8, 18, then 32. Right.
Means
so this is where it comes from.
Yes. Okay.
Okay. What about others? I haven't asked everyone. Safwan, Samaira, Yusra, you get the idea?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Very good. Awesome. Please write a note here.
Second, you just roll up.
Scroll up. Okay. Fine. Then raise your hand if you're done. Then I will write a note.
Okay. Sir, I was.
So this chapter is very easy. Just please read every day for 15 minutes, for 10 minutes also. Just read like newspaper reading. I know that you must not have ever read a newspaper. Anyone has ever read a newspaper?
Whenever I'm coming to India.
Yes, sir.
Yes. So if you read a newspaper, you don't read the whole newspaper. How do you read it? You read almost all of the headlines, correct?
Yes, sir.
But you will read that particular column which will interest you, right?
Yes, sir.
So you have to do that type of newspaper reading when you're reading my notes daily. But that is for daily, okay? When you are daily reading my notes, what I'm just asking is just flip the pages, see the topics. And for that, you have to make very proper notes, highlight the topics, write the topics in bold or underline them. Okay, something, there should be some sign that this is the topic and this is the content of the topic. Maybe use some different color of pen. And highlighting, I like highlighting because it just shows that it is the topic. So you read all the topics. Now, if you see some topic which interests you, or you think that let me read this, then you can read that. Otherwise, please read the headlines of my notes daily. You can do that in less than 10 minutes. I hope so. You can read the headlines in less than 10 minutes in my notebook, right?
Yes, sir.
So please just make a resolution of some kind that I will just newspaper type of reading I will do for the chemistry mocks.
Done.
Okay. Now this is for the daily thing that you have to read the notes daily. But when you have a class, then 15 minutes before the class, you will get in your table with my chemistry notebook and read the previous lecture. Now read the previous lecture. Now, an important habit to maintain is that either you write the date before every lecture starts, or what you can do is, for example, this is chapter number 2. This is the first lecture. So what I usually do is that when I am studying a things, then I write it like this, first lecture. Okay, then I highlight this also. Okay, first lecture, then I will highlight it. Now, why is that? Because if you will see now, then you will remember that, okay, in the second lecture, sir has taught that, in the third lecture, sir has taught that. So it will be in sequence, the order of the topics and content will be in sequence. Okay, so 15 minutes before, and 15 minutes after. This is when you have the chemistry class. Okay, 15 minutes before and 15 minutes after. And if you don't have the chemistry class, then you will read 10 minutes headlines. But if you have any topic that interests you, you will read that, read the content also. Okay, now if you make this happen, usually chemistry is a subject with demands relatively more memory, I will say, more rote learning, I would say, and also comparative to chemistry, biology requires more memorization, right? If I compare physics, chemistry, biology, then I would say that physics requires the least amount of memorization. Chemistry requires some amount of memorization. Biology requires more amount of memorization. Now, this doesn't make a subject bad because we have been memorizing different things. For example, we cannot be speaking English if we didn't memorize the 26 alphabets of English, right? We will not be very much equipped and fast with calculation if we didn't memorize the tables. So we have to memorize a few things just to make our lives easy. Now, coming to the next thing, which is, we have done two things. The first is azimuthal quantum number. Oh, I wanted to write a note regarding the azimuthal quantum number. So write a note. The value of AQN for a given PQN will be always less than N. Okay, that means N will be always greater than L for a given principal quantum number. Okay, for a given principal quantum number. Right, also a question regarding to this. Give the answer in chat. Which of the following sets of quantum numbers are not possible? The only criteria that you will check is n should be always greater than l. Okay, in each of these sets of quantum numbers, n should be greater than l. That's it. Yes, Mariam, correct.
Sir, you mean which one is wrong? Yeah, we should send which one is not possible.
Yes. Yeah, Yusra, correct. Now, Samaira, correct. Shakir, correct. Ikra, correct. Okay, how many have answered? Mariam, Yusra, Samaira, Ikra, Shakir, Aisha. Yes, Safwan, correct. Aisha, please reconsider your answer. You seem to be always in a hurry. Take some deep breaths, read the condition, try the question once more. This is for Aisha. Yes, Aisha. See, I will tell the answer that B is the right answer, that it is not possible. Okay, it is not possible. Those who have not got the answer,
sir, B. I messaged you B again later if you choose.
Yes. Now you have messaged me B. Yeah. And if there is anyone who has some doubt, they won't ask. They will read this 10 times and then they will read this question. Okay. Because this is pretty simple. It just might not be clicking for you right now. So you may read this 10 times. N is greater than L. The sign may have some sort of, it may sometimes confuse you. You will read it in a wrong way, but it is all there. Okay. Now let us move on to the next quantum number. That is the magnetic quantum number. So it is magnetic. Okay, sorry for this. Magnetic. Quantum number. It is magnetic quantum number. It is denoted by which letter?
M.
Yes.
For M.
In your NCERT, you must see that it is denoted by M with a subscript of L. Okay, this is a subscript of L. But don't worry, this M is also the one of the correct way of denoting magnetic quantum number. I will refer sometimes magnetic quantum number as MQN. Okay, as MQN. What is magnetic quantum number? It will give the, please write these things with me.
So you wrote here magnetic quantum number is value is M, yeah? You give the value M and or what?
M, it is denoted by M or it is denoted by M with a subscript of L. Subscript of L.
Okay, thank you.
It gives the idea. Of orbital. Rather, I should say, it gives the idea of number of orbitals. In a given subshell. In a given subshell. So M is equal to, the values of M is equal to values of M is equal to minus L to plus L. Minus L to plus L. The number of orbital in a given subshell is equal to the number of values of M. Number of values of M. Okay. You will count them 1, 2, 3, 4. How many values of M are present? Not how much. How many values are there? Okay. How many values? I don't know which number is this. Calculate the number of orbitals present in following subshell. Part A is, okay, I will write the part A as soon as we have completed the list of points. Just let me know if you have completed it. Written the question, raise your hand. You're just waiting for Aisha and Safwan.
Sir, I have completed. Actually, my laptop was hanging. That's why I wasn't able to.
Raise hand? Okay.
Yeah.
Aisha, I would recommend that you log in with two devices. Use the screen of the laptop for writing down the notes. And for audio, use your phone. Don't connect the audio from your laptop. You can try that. It would require a bit of coordination, but it will help you. Safwan, please raise your hand if you're done.
एक सेकंड सर.
अरे आप आपका हाथ बहुत दर्द कर रहा है क्या जिम से? जी.
अरे नहीं सर.
I'm just joking. Just, you have to write fast. Everyone is done, na? Okay, others they can start for S subshell. Okay, for S subshell. How will we do this? What is the value of L for S subshell, Yusra? What is the value of L for S subshell? Yes, Yusra. No, no. Can you please be a bit louder? Value of L.
Minus L to plus L.
What is L? Please see what I am asking. I am not asking the value of M. I am asking the value of L for S subshell. Ikra?
Zero.
Very good. Zero. Okay, next. M is equal to, for a given subshell, the values of M is equal to minus L to plus L. So what will be the value of M? Samaira, what will be the value of M?
Zero.
Zero only, na? Zero. You don't have to, this value zero, it does not represent anything. It does not represent anything. Now tell me how many values of M did you get? How many values of M did you get, Samaira? Yes, Samaira, how many values did you get for M?
Two.
Two?
One.
Yes, you said one. Now we got only one value. Now this is very important. This distinction is very important. What value we got for M, it is zero. How many values we got for M? That is one. Does everyone understand the difference between what value and how many values? Shakir?
Yes,
sir. Yusra?
Yes, sir.
Yes, Shakir?
Sir, how many values is one? And how much is zero, yeah?
Yeah, how much is zero? Very good.
How much is zero?
Okay. That means how many orbitals in the S subshell? This is equal to, there is one orbital. Okay, one orbital. How many values of N? One. The same will be the number of orbitals, we have written it in the last point. The number of orbitals in a given subshell is equal to the number of values of M. So the number of values of M is equal to 1. That is why the number of orbitals in S subshell is also equal to 1. Now for B, P subshell, the value of L is equal to how much, Ikra? Ikra, the value of L is how much for P?
1.
Very good. Now the value of M will be equal to minus L to plus L. Please calculate this, the number of values, and tell me how many values of M are there. Tell me how many values of M are there.
Sir, we should send in chat.
Chat. Yes. Okay. Yes, Shakir, correct. Very good. Mariam, correct. Very good. Minus L, 2 plus L, Ikra, 2. So from minus L, 2 plus L.
Yes. Okay.
Not and, okay? It is not minus L and plus L. It is minus L, 2 plus L. Samaira? You also correct it? Okay, Yusra, you also have to correct it? Okay, Ikra, no, minus L to plus L. Okay, some people are having some difficulty, so I will ask Ikra. You tell me, minus L is how much? Minus 1?
Yes, sir. Minus 1,
2?
0. Okay, minus 1, 0.
Right. Yes, correct. So, but you answered something different? You answered one value.
Yes.
Achha, theek hai, koi baat nahi. Sometimes it doesn't strike in the first go. That's well and fine. Plus one. Okay. This will be equal to how many values of M? 3. And how many orbitals of P? That is equal to 3 orbitals. Now in the C, I will directly ask for D subshell. What is the value of L? and then you will calculate the value of m, and then you will tell me this question same, how many value of m, then you will tell me how many orbitals in D in the chat. Okay, let me just write for D it is equal to 2. This will be again minus L, 2 plus L. Samaira, correct. Very good, Mariam. Yes, Ikra, very good. Shakir and Yusra, please, once more, you are missing one, something. You are missing something, do it again. Yes, Yusra, now it is correct. Yes, Shakir, now it is correct. I think that was a mistake or what? Okay.
Yes, sir, I knew the answer, but by mistake, I just wrote
the answer. Okay, that's fine. Achha, let us see others. So only some have answered. If you have answered, please raise your hand. If you have answered it, please raise your hand. Okay, so waiting for Safwan and Aisha. What happened, Safwan?
Sir, Sundari sir, bas par principle bata dijiye.
अच्छा नहीं आप स्टार्टिंग से आप हमें यू रीड दिस विथ योर माइक ऑन ना फ्रॉम ए पार्ट कैन यू रीड दैट फ्रॉम ए पार्ट विथ योर माइक ऑन सफवान
सर आप बोल दीजिए बस एक बार बता दीजिए
अरे नहीं इट्स नॉट आई ओके आई कैन टेल यू दैट बट दैट्स नॉट द बेस्ट वे माइनस एल टू प्लस एल टेल मी व्हाट इज द वैल्यू ऑफ माइनस L here, what will be minus L sub 1?
Minus 1.
Why minus 1? L is equal to 2, na?
Achha. Minus 2. Okay.
2, what will be plus L?
2.
Plus 2. What are there between minus 2 to plus 2? That is minus 2. Then there is minus 1. Then there is 0. Then there is plus 1. Then there is plus 2. So how many values of M are there sub 1? How five. Many? So how many orbitals in B?
Five.
Easy?
Okay, sir.
What about Aisha? Now again, you have the last thing. CB. Calculate for F subshell. Yes, Shakir, correct. Very good. Yes, Mariam, correct. Very good. Samaira, correct. Yusra, correct. Again, Safwan, I'm waiting for your answer. Safwan has not answered, and who has not answered? I cannot see Ikra's answer. Ikra, you have some doubt? Okay, fine.
No, sir.
Yes, yes. Okay, correct answer. And whose answer can I? Mariam has answered. Samaira has answered. Yusra has also answered. Okay, I don't know whether Aisha is present or not. I cannot see either Aisha writing anything or saying anything. Safwan, waiting for your answer.
Hello, sir.
Fashion.
Yeah, actually, after trying a lot, now my mic offense, actually, my Zoom is lagging a lot.
Okay.
Sir,
tomorrow I will use my dad's
laptop. Yes, Aisha, what?
Like, it's just for today. Tomorrow I will use my dad's.
Yeah, that would be good. So, L is equal to 3. M is equal to minus L.
See, my laptop is hanging.
2 plus L. So minus L is minus 3, 2 plus 3, which will be equal to minus 3, minus 2, minus 1, 0, plus 1, plus 2, plus 3. Now this will be equal to how much? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7.
7 values.
Yeah. Now, write a note. Write a note, okay? And this note will help you a lot. First thing is that, now here C and the S subshell, see the value of L and see the value of M, okay? Just look at it, 0, 0, 0, 0, okay, just look at it. See the value of L and see the maximum value of L. See the value of L and the maximum value of L. Again, see the value of L and the maximum value of M. And in F subshell also, you see the value of L and the maximum value of L, okay? Maximum value of M. Here we can say that for a given subshell, value of L will be either greater than, or equal to value of M, right? For example, if I have L is equal to 3, then the value of M will be either 3 or it will be less than 3. Yes or no? Does anyone has any doubt? If the value of L is 3, then the value of M can be 3 or it will be less than 3. It cannot be more than 3, right?
Yes, sir.
Now, this is the criteria that you will check, okay? If you have to check the values of a set of quantum numbers, okay? Set of quantum numbers. So, now, next point. I will give you a short formula to calculate the number of orbitals in different subshell. Number of orbitals in a given subshell is equal to 2 into L plus 1. 2 into L plus 1. You can try this with anyone. We can try this for 3 also. So what will be the number of orbitals in a given subshell? If L is equal to 3, that is L is equal to F subshell, then it is 3 to the 6 plus 1, 7. For D, the value of L for D is equal to 2, and the number of orbitals will be equal to 2 into 2 plus 1, that is equal to 5. Okay. Now, next, right? We have not done that. So let us first do a few questions on the given value of subshell and etc. Question. Which of the following? Set of quantum numbers are not possible. N is equal to 2, L is equal to 3, let's not write 3, L is equal to 1, M is equal to 1. Okay, this is a set of quantum. Is this possible or not? So from L, N to L, you will check the condition for N to L, N and L. From L to M, you will then check the condition for L and M. Okay, you will start with N and L, then you will check for L and M. A, B, C, D. Yes, Maryam, correct. Yusra, correct.
Sir, what is N?
What is N? You tell me what is N. See your notes.
Sir?
See your notes. I'm telling, see your notes and tell me what is N.
Okay.
If you don't find it, then let me know, okay? No, Aisha, please see.
Okay, sir, thank you. I got it.
Got it?
Okay. Yes.
Yes, Samaira, correct? Aisha, you are again, I would say that you are in a hurry. Please check each and every option. Start with N and L. See if that condition is fulfilled. Then check for L and M.
Present.
No, wrong.
Okay, wait, wait.
Well, are you guessing? Huh?
No, sir, not guess because...
So then tell me, then tell in chat what is not right. Which of the quantum number is not correct? N, L or M? Tell me in chat, na, which is not correct, if in D, if it is not a guess. And this is for Aisha also.
I thought that...
No. In the chat, tell me whether N is not right, N is not having the allowed value, or whether L is not having the allowed value. Yes, Aisha, it is correct, no? Safwan, it is correct, very good. Aisha, it is correct, very good. Yes, Samara has done it right, okay. You guys are going fine. You just need to have some patience. Okay. Don't try to be fast. Just try to be right as of now. Quantum numbers abhi ek ghanta pehle aap log koi jante bhi nahi the. Naam bhi nahi suna tha. Hai na? Naam suna hoga, but you would not have been knowing the details of quantum numbers. So it is obvious that you will be a bit slow. So please be a bit slow, but there is no chance of getting it wrong. Okay.
I get my answer. It's maybe correct.
Now it is correct. So the conditions are very easy. N should be greater than L, and L should be either greater than or equal to M. That is just the condition. Okay. So if someone has any difficulty with this mathematical symbol of greater than and greater than equal to, then it will be a problem. But since you have passed the 10th standard, you must not have a problem. If you have a problem, that's okay. We can deal with that also, but most probably you will not have a problem. So from N to L, we will see that 2 is greater than 1. It is fine. Then we will move from L to M. L and M are equal, then it is fine. N to L, 4 is greater than 2. Okay, good. 2 is equal to 2. That is also fine. 5 to 3, yeah, that is fine. 5 is greater than 3. But then we come to L and M, that is 3 and 5. No, this is not right. That is why here the problem is with this quantum number of M, right? This quantum number M, it should have a value of 3 or less than 3. Okay. So that is why C is the option for the question. C is the option for the question. Okay. Now, let us do a different type of question now. Let us do the same question, but let me see if you guys get the right answer now. Which of the following set of quantum numbers are not possible? Which of the
जानती हो यार, मेरा माइक बहुत बेकार काम कर रहा है।
नहीं, आपका माइक बहुत सही काम कर रहा है, कोई बात नहीं है। Yes, thank you.
Sir?
Eight seconds, Safwan. जी आपका ये सफा
सर आप लोग टाइमिंग
पहले जाना है आपको
जी
पहले जाना है क्या आपको
हाँ सर वो आप लोग टाइमिंग चेंज नहीं कर सकते क्या सर असर के बाद सर असर के बाद से लेके मगरिब के अजान से पहले
अरे असर के बाद हम तो आपको मगरिब के बाद से पढ़ा रहे हैं इंडिया के वक्त के हिसाब से
सर यहाँ पर मेरी मगरिब की नमाज मिस हो जाती सर यहाँ तकबीर नहीं मिल रही मस्जिद में नमाज नहीं हो रही खजा करना पड़ा
अच्छा आपको मगरिब कितनी बजे हो रही है आप बताइए
सर मगरिब इधर 5:21 को है और इशा 6:52 को और असर 2:51 कुछ है
देखिए इशा तो कजा नहीं होगी है ना
हाँ सर इशा हो जाती लेकिन मगरिब
मगरिब का नहीं हम समझ रहे मगरिब का वक्त ये एक सेकंड जस्ट आप तो आप रियाद में कहाँ हैं आप
दमाम
अच्छा आप दमाम में हैं तो एक सेकंड आपके यहाँ अभी टाइम कितना हो रहा है आपके यहाँ टाइम अभी 6:14 हो रहा है
17 सर
आपका टाइम आपका घड़ी सब फास्ट है 6:14 हो रहा है
यस सर
है ना हाँ 6:14 or 6:13 इट वुड बी और मगरिब आपने कहा है 5:21 में है ओके आपको टाइम चेंज कराना है ठीक है किया जा सकता है सफान किया जा सकता है ठीक है
ठीक सर
हाँ तो आपका टाइमिंग क्या होगा आपकी क्लास 6:30 तक होती है ना
जी सर
तो हम आपको 6:30 से 8:30 कर सकते हैं
सर सुबह के टाइम करो ना सर रात के टाइम
नहीं सुबह के टाइम तो फिर कोई स्टूडेंट नहीं रहेगा ना आप बस अकेले बोल रहे हो सुबह के टाइम बिकॉज आई हैव द सिमिलर काइंड ऑफ बैच व्हिच व्हिच आई विल बी टीचिंग द सेम थिंग्स दैट इज व्हाई आई एम सेइंग दैट 6:30 to 8:30 सुबह के वक्त कोई बैच नहीं बिकॉज स्कूल भी रहता है बच्चों का
सर 3 बजे से यहाँ की 3 बजे से लेके 5 बजे तक पैसा कर लो
अच्छा तो आप मेरा मगरिब छुड़वाना चाह रहे हैं
सर आपकी हो गई सर लेकिन मैं तो अंदर मसला हुआ सर ठीक है सर कोई बात नहीं ये चलने
दो सर लाइक इफ समवन वांट्स टू प्ले दे कैन टेक द ब्रेक ऑफ 6 लाइक 10 मिनट्स एंड दे कैन प्ले राइट
हाँ नहीं हो सकता बट इट ब्रेक्स द फ्लो ना इट ब्रेक्स द फ्लो आई अंडरस्टैंड इट इज अ प्रॉब्लम अच्छा
कोई बात नहीं सर
अच्छा सफवान I will talk to people and if it is possible na then we will hold the class for 10 minutes 10 minutes is it fine if you pray at home
ठीक सर
चलेगा चल ठीक है I will talk
sir, to... then we can extend 10 minutes more for tuitions right
yeah we can extend 10 minutes more
yeah sir
Sir, can you scroll it a little up? I just want to take a little note.
Good. Shakir, you have not written the right answer for this one. Ikra is right, Yusra is right, Maryam is right. Oh. Yeah. Only this many students have answered. Samaira, I'm waiting for your answer. Samaira, yes, correct now. Shakir, please check the answer for the second question.
Okay, now you can scroll down.
In this question, what will happen? We will check again. Is n greater than l? Yes, it is right. So a is fine. Is l greater than m or equal to m? That is good. N, this is greater than l. L is equal to m. That is fine. N is equal to l? No, that is not right. Because n should be greater than l. N cannot be equal to l. Okay, n cannot be equal to l. That is why the option for this question is C. Yes, Aisha, correct.
Sir, but
what?
Up you wrote there, sir, that n should be greater than l.
Yeah. So is n greater than l?
They are equal.
So it is not greater, na? I have written greater than sign. I have not given greater than or equal to. Mm-hmm. Okay, right? Got it? Okay. So here the problem is with this guy here. Okay. Right. All right, the last quantum number, spin quantum number. Denoted by the letter S, okay? It's denoted by letter S. But if you look at your NCERT textbook, if you look at the NCERT textbook, they have again in this spin quantum number also, they sometimes define it as MS or something, okay? So this is S, and I will sometimes refer to this as SQN. This is small. Please write this with me. It gives the idea of motion of electron in an atom. Secondly, the motion of electron around its own axis is called spin of electron. Next, for every value of m, for every value of m, there are two possible values of s. What are those two possible values? So see, if a particular electron is revolving, it is rotating around its own axis motion, that is spin of the electron, it can be either clockwise direction or anti-clockwise direction. Okay, so for clockwise, S is equal to plus half, and for anti-clockwise, S is equal to minus half. Okay. S is equal to plus half for clockwise, for anti-clockwise, S is equal to minus half. Please write this. I'm really happy with all of you guys because mostly you have got the right answer. You studied quantum numbers for the first time and you have got each of the answers, almost all of them have got the right answer. And most of the times what happens is when I teach this many kids, I was talking to Samira regarding this quantum numbers, then it take completely 2 hours to finish till spin quantum numbers, or at least sometimes more than 2 hours to finish spin quantum numbers. But if the pace of students are nice, if they are grasping easily and rapidly, it gets completed in less than 2 hours. Around it would take, if I have a very good student, it takes 1 hour and around 45 minutes to complete till spin quantum numbers with questions that we have already done. But you guys have also reached around 150.
So for us, it's something like 5 minutes. It's 6:25 right now.
No, it is not 6:25. It is 6:21.
Maybe my clock starts.
Yes. So I'm very happy with all of you guys. Okay. So if you have this type of quiz, now I understand that you all will have the inorganic chemistry and organic chemistry pretty good. You may. There are some students, I understand, who have a bit of hesitation. Yeah, there are a bit reluctant with calculations. So that may be a point of difficulty in physics also and in physical chemistry, that is applying physics to chemistry. So but organic and inorganic, you will score good. So it's a good thing to know your strength and your weakness. If you are having some strength, please hold on to that, those strengths, okay? You will be getting advices like jo cheez weak hai na us pe zyada time dena chahiye. That is true. बट जो चीज आपकी सही है उस पर ज्यादा आप फोकस कीजिए. राइट, अटेंशन एंड टाइम, दीज आर द टू मोस्ट वैल्यूएबल थिंग्स दैट यू कैन गिव टू एनीवन. सो इफ यू फोकस राइट, दैट इज वन टाइप ऑफ करेंसी, एंड इफ यू गिव टाइम, दैट इज अनदर टाइप ऑफ करेंसी. यू मे गिव मोर टाइम टू द वीकर पोर्शन, बट यू शुड फोकस ऑन द स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ योर्स, बिकॉज दे विल ओनली लीड यू फॉरवर्ड. ओके, इफ कैलकुलेशंस आर अ बिट वीक, देन व्हाट यू कैन डू, यू डोंट हैव टू सॉल्व केमिस्ट्री फॉर दैट. You have to learn the tables, okay? If you are not practice, it won't make you very good in chemistry. If somebody has memorized tables till 20, the multiplication tables till 20, they will easily go through the physical portion of this chemistry. And after that, you will get something of log. Does anyone know log? You have got introduction from in physics about log. Yes, sir, or no, sir? No?
No,
no, sir.
No, sir.
Okay, fine. So, okay. After a few classes in physics, after some classes or some chapters, you will be introduced to this log. In mathematics, students must have got log in relation and functions, no? Functions is in 11th, no? Functions is in 11th.
Yes, sir.
So, you have not got till log?
No, sir.
So it is near. Log is coming, as is winter.